This is Dennis Body welcoming you to Great Music at St. James for a new season of Classical Sundays at 6. Coming to you from St. James in the City on Wilshire Boulevard, Classical Sundays at 6 is presented most Sundays each month, live at 6 p.m., October through May. This week, we feature the International Laureates Organ Series. Here to introduce our guest artist this evening is Canon James Buonamoni.
Good evening, everyone. I'm so pleased to see you here because the LA Marathon, I know, has caused some road closures, and congratulations, you made it. We may get some latecomers, but that's okay. My name is James Buonamoni. I'm the music director here. I'm so pleased to see you and to welcome also online anyone viewing from around the world our live stream. We are very honored to have, for the very first time, Miss Nicole Keller with us. She is a newly appointed faculty member of the School of Music, Dance, and Theater at the University of Michigan. She has concertized extensively throughout the United States and Europe in such notable places as St. Patrick's Cathedral in New York City and Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris, and many other places as well. And you can read about Ms. Keller, a little bit more information is in your program. Also in your program, there is a QR code, and if you click on or scan that, you can get more information on upcoming concerts. And I want to especially invite you next Sunday. We have a special event at 4:15 next Sunday, which is Palm Sunday. We're pleased to host the Select Choir from Walla Walla University, Washington. They're called E-Cantori, and they're doing an absolutely splendid program of music for evensong. So we hope you can come back next Sunday, 4:15 p.m. If you are moved to make a donation tonight, of course, we're always very grateful for that. You can put your envelope in the baskets at the rear of the church as you leave, or again, the QR code can be used for that purpose to make a donation online. So thank you for being here, and please join me in welcoming Nicole Keller.
Thank you all so much for being here today, and I feel like I should say happy marathon day. You made it. It's really a joy to be here and experience this wonderful instrument in this wonderful space. And I've chosen these pieces today to show off actually the many different instruments that are inside this extraordinary pipe organ. So the next couple of sets of pieces are very different from each other. This next set of variations by Jan Sweelinck is called Mein junges Leben hat ein End, or My Young Life Has an End. And it's a variation on a set on a German folk song that Sweelinck would possibly have known through some of his students. He was very famous during his lifetime, and many people came to Amsterdam to study with him. So you'll hear him using different keyboard figurations, which he was very well known for improvising, actually, during his time period. And then after that, we'll hear Franck's monumental Choral No. 3 in A minor. And even though it's called a chorale, the tune that you hear, the hymn tune inside of it was composed by Franck himself, not a pre-existing tune. And the whole piece is really framed around this really gorgeous hymn tune, but you'll hear these virtuosic events and these more calm events, and you'll hear them sort of at war with each other during this piece. And in the end, you know, we get to see them sort of triumph together, as opposed to good triumphing over evil. Everyone sort of wins in the end. So I hope you enjoy these next two pieces.
Thank you.
next two sets of pieces are from here in the United States, for the most part. The next three pieces are, of course, from the iconic composer George Shearing, a name you probably recognize, but likely don't associate with the organ. These three pieces are taken from a set of arrangements of old American hymn tunes that he wrote, and I think they work so well on a colorful instrument like this. And you hear echoes of different types of organs, perhaps, inside these pieces as well. And after that is a set of pieces that I put together called An American Suite. There are four pieces by four different composers with four very different voices, but I think they accompany each other well, much like four movements of a sonata would. So I hope you enjoy these new pieces, and hopefully they will add some new areas to your own repertoire for organ music and some new composers for you to discover.
Thank you. Thank you.